pure touch, instinct, confidence.
Western United have won the A-League Championship.
And a warm welcome to Combank Stadium for the continuation of Pride Celebration Round at the home of a club designed to be inclusive of everyone in the diverse region of Western Sydney. Tonight, the Wanderers engage in a local scrap with the new boys from down the road in Macarthur FC. It's a derby, albeit not the derby. So it's not just Pride Round, it's also local Pride Round for these two. A week on from that madcap 90 minutes against Adelaide, the Wanderers going in search of just their third victory since the World Cup break. But one of those was in their best performance of the season here against the Bulls on New Year's Day. In truth, their recent displays have probably deserved more. Perhaps tonight is when they will put it all together. Macarthur, of course, played out a marathon of their own last week due to the heat and the storms. And they are very much in transition. Just the one win since the departure of Dwight York, who led the team to Australia Cup success at this venue only last October. Things change pretty quickly in football, and the Bulls certainly hoping for a change in fortunes this evening. To the team news, three changes for the Wanderers. Adama Traore, of course, is suspended, so Tom Beadling moves across to left back. Marcelo returns after injury in the centre. Elsewhere, it's a first start for Miloš Ninković since the Sydney derby back in November, as Oli Bozanić drops down to the bench. And Amor Layuni is rewarded for his goal and assist off the pine against Adelaide with his first Wanderer start in place of Kasuni Yenge. Milanović, Yenge and Bozanić, all potential impact players off the bench. Yeni Mbokoto serves the second game of his two-match ban. Now, three changes for the Bulls as well. Tommy Uskok returns after suspension and takes over the captaincy as Jonathan Aspropotamitis is relegated to the bench for the first time this season. Kieran Backus returns in midfield against his old club, with Danny De Silva expected to push further forward to fill the gap left by that season-ending injury to Ulysses Davila. And Alhassan Toure moves to lead the line in place of Bachana Arabuli. Ali Ugla, another former Wanderer, makes his starting debut for the Bulls after an impressive cameo against the Jets last week. It's been a warm day in the Harbour City, but conditions have cooled somewhat. And two excellent shot stoppers at opposite ends of the field today. Philip Curto, of course, the penalty-saving specialist. He's saved three this season, with another having been missed by Becca Mikkeltanter of the Jets. However, Curto was beaten from the spot by Rami Nazarene here on New Year's Day in that 4-0 drubbing by the Wanderers. Lawrence Thomas has six clean sheets this season, which is the joint most, along with Tom Glover of Melbourne City. Curto on the right there has five clean sheets to his name. So a really important match for both these clubs. The Wanderers looking to go joint second. Macarthur looking to keep in touch with the final spots. There is Amor Layuni, his home debut tonight. But boy, wasn't it good last week off the bench against Adelaide United. A goal and an assist for the three-times capped Tunisian international. In the technical zone, Marco Rodin and Nilis Tojovski know each other well, of course. They had a season together as players with Sydney United back in 97-98 in the NSL. But this is the first time they've met as coaches. Stojovski, part of the Mariners team that won the grand final against the Wanderers back in 2013. Our referee this evening is Kurt Ams, his first game in the middle since taking charge of a rather ill-tempered Adelaide Macarthur game back in January. And you might remember he sent off both Ben Warland of the Reds and Jake Holman of the Bulls. So off we go in Parramatta, just the seventh meeting between these two local rivals. And that win for the Wanderers here on New Year's Day stands alone as the Wanderers' solitary success. But they're probably slight favourites again here tonight, Daniel McBreed, would you say?
Yeah, I would say, Simon. Good evening, everybody. The performance last week going forward, Amola Uni in particular looked like a very good acquisition. All the goal-scoring woes we spoke about, speaking about with Western Sydney. Maybe they've found their answer there. On Macarthur's side, though, it's a real opportunity for them to step up as a team. Obviously, the loss of Uli Davila for the season give them an opportunity to bond, and it could galvanise them as a squad.
He will certainly be missed, a player of such quality. Of course, provider of goals and assists. Here's Al Hassan Touré, the point of the attack tonight, firing in the first shot of the game, which was easily blocked by the Wanderers back line. And for Craig Noon on the left, who's still without a goal, perhaps strangely this season, although has contributed four assists to the Bulls' cause. Goes from Sushnia. Pretty accurate release it was too. And Matt Miller will dart into the box. Here's Danny De Silva. He was just hustled out of it in the end. The ball's midfielder by Marcelo.
It was a nice run from Matt Miller down that right-hand side. Fine ball in. It's right in his path. See there, he can take it forward. Skips into the box. Bulls top goal scorer this season. Right back.
And those are the sorts of areas you like to see Danny De Silva in. He's played a bit deeper most of this season, but certainly capable of playing that more attacking role.
Well, I think that's his more preferred position, isn't it, Simon? Ball player. No assists or goals this season. I think that's mainly due to that deeper role. Hopefully tonight he can correct that stat for the Macarthur fans.
Fill the sizeable boots of Ulysses Davila, who is in the stadium tonight watching his teammates after that knee surgery during the week. Gabriel Clure has kept the ball in, and a little threaded pass through has found Ninkovic, and a chance for Borrello. Goodness me, he's on fire at the moment, Brandon Borrello. It's his 20th A-League goal, his seventh of the season. He's turning into a real potent threat for the red and black.
Well, we spoke about him in the pre-match. Harvey Norman replay will show. It's a ball inside that Milos Nikovic gets onto the end of, and it's a great run. Confidence. And here it is, the strike. Six goals in nine games now, and we're only 3 minutes into that ninth game. Wonderful ball from Nikovic into the path. Doesn't think twice. First time across the goal into the back of the net. Wonderful start for Western Sydney.
Well, all the talk this season has been about who's going to score the goals for the Wanderers. Brandon Borrello says, it's me.
He certainly put his hand up since that World Cup campaign in the break. Wasn't booked in for that squad, but he has been on fire on the back end.
Well, the best possible starts for the Wanderers. A complete reverse for the Bulls. They've won just one of their last six and two of the last eight since they were trounced here on New Year's Day by Western Sydney. Let's see how they respond. Matt Miller, who's been one of their best this season. Really good, determined run, but it doesn't get any reward in the end. Goal kick for the Wanderers.
Well, that's the 19th goal that Macarthur have conceded away from home this season in the ninth game. And better than that, Milos Nikovic afforded too much space.
Gabriel Clure galloping forward. He was caught there by Noon. Advantage played though, Borrello. And they were in again there, the Wanderers, but for that intervention from Sushnia. And Clure was fouled in back play. Might need a bit of attention.
It was a great run from Clure. Brandon Borrello held his run up on the right-hand side. That is a late challenge, and you can see the Western Sydney Wanderers talking to the referee now, saying, well, why is that not a yellow card?
Well, the VAR review has been called for. There's a tackle from behind by Craig Noon, and Kurt Hams has come across. And that angle doesn't look too clever, does it, from Craig Noon's point of view? He's raking down the Achilles of Gabriel Clure. He could be in a spot of bother here.
I think he's in trouble. You can see there he's late. He comes down with the studs on the back of the ankle, and Gabriel Clure is lucky that doesn't come away with anything worse as an injury.
What's the verdict here for Craig New? Yep, thought it might be. What a disastrous start for Macarthur. Already a goal down. Now they've got to play 85 minutes plus a man short.
Well, you couldn't ask for a worse start for Mile Sturjoski.
And Kurt Hams is going to bring them back. He's saying we'll have a free kick for the Wanderers instead of the corner. Previous phase of play which led to the corner kick, of course.
Just thinking there for Craig Noon, it's just an experienced player as well. Sure, if it was just early in the game and thought he might have been able to get away with one, but not in this day and age. It was a dangerous challenge.
Long night ahead potentially for Macarthur, but fortunately for the Wanderers, that free kick is a bit too long from Morgan Schneiderlin. Here's another look at it. Doesn't matter how many times you watch it, doesn't get any prettier.
No, it doesn't.
Reorganisation for Mile Sturjoski and his side. Ivan Vujica, De Silva. Turned back by Holman for Vujica again. Now Sushnia. And along the defensive line for Thomas Larbuskok. Matt Miller. He is so strong, Matt Miller. First effort blocked. Cross does come in. De Silva's not going to win too many in the air. Mertula gets it half away. And Marcelo completes the job. Toure. Mighty shift over to the left-hand side with De Silva almost playing as a false nine, if you like.
Yeah, it looks as though that maybe what's happening. It's been a pretty tough learning curve and start to A-League coaching for Mile Sturjoski.
A useful ball from Sushnia. Uglan trying to dig it out. Beedling wins the throw for the home side. Let's go down to Tristan McManus. Evening, Tristan. Some start to this game.
Oh, fantastic start, and the crowd are full behind it as well. It was interesting because I was watching Clure here. He looks like he's in business tonight, and the pace of him is ridiculous. He was telling Leuni to pull out wide, so he knew exactly what he wanted to do, and granted it might have been two or three steps that Leuni stepped out to the side, but it made all that space for Ninkovic, and then Brandon Brella does what Brandon Brella does. Again, Clure highly involved in that red card as well. He was just too quick for Noon. I mean, Craig Noon, we know he's not that type of player, but he made the tackle. Clure got away from him and he took the angle he had to go.
Yep, can't disagree with any of that. Thanks, Tristan. By the way, Miloš Nikovic, first start since the Sydney Derby. He got the assist for the winner that day for Cassini Yenge. Another one to add to the tally tonight to tee up Brandon Borello. Rodan could not have written this script any better so far as his team is concerned in these opening stages. Schneiderlin almost got caught by Kieran Backus. Oh, Minkovic lunged in a bit there on Villa, but on we go. Ewenhoff. Kluwer. Straight at Backus. One in the air, easily by Mertula. Borrello is too strong for Holman and too clever on the ground for him, but not so for Sushnia. Now Neuenhoff, Layuni, crossing into a dangerous area. Malfitano was looking to sneak in on the blind side of Miller. They'll recycle it, Western Sydney. Schneiderlin, going around the outside. Thread the gap there for Nikovic. There was a shout for a handball there from the Wanderers. Kurt Amp's not interested.
Well, I'm all Layuni's. Good again, isn't he? Stands up his defender, moves the ball. This is the shout for handball. Miller even looking in the right direction. I don't think you can call that. Turn of pace and the movement of the ball off the mark from Layuni. We saw last week he left defenders in his wake, and he's done it already again tonight. He looks an exciting prospect.
Brought down here by Danny De Silva. Accomplished footballer playing in that more advanced role today. In fact, now probably the most advanced player for the Bulls. Wide for Toure. Ewenhoff. Malfitano trying to reward that run of a ball, Layuni, and he's dug it out beautifully. Chance perhaps here for Tom Veedling. Still alive, and Malfitano earns a corner. It might have been more for Western Sydney, who look in the mood tonight.
Yeah, they do. And again, it's the pace of Layuni in behind. Desperation to keep that ball alive as well.
French import Morgan Schneiderlin to deliver. Once Kurt Hams has sorted out a bit of nonsense involving Layuni and Holman initially, right under the nose of Philip Curto. Schneiderlin's ball and Curto's catch. Utilise that pace of Ali Ugla, the former Western Sydney Wanderers junior. Now Ewenhoff doing all the chasing back. It's a sort of dirty work you have to do in that defensive midfield role. He's got the engines for it, Callum Ewenhoff.
He relishes it, doesn't he? Seems to thrive in that position, the work rate, getting stuck in, winning the ball.
Marcelo directing Tom Beedling forward. Mertula. Going to see a lot of this with the Western Sydney Wanderers having a lot of possession. Balls trying to spring the counter-attacks when they can. Didn't quite work out for Ninkovic. And Curto to clear up field where there is nobody within about 15, 20 metres wearing a Bulls shirt. Schneiderlin. For Neuenhoff and Marcelo. Beedling. Routine for Philip Curto, making his 101st appearance in the Isuzu UTE Ali Men's competition tonight. Top the ton against Newcastle in that game that seemed to go on forever. last week due to the weather conditions. 239 minutes, the longest game to complete in A-League men's history.
So you're saying that there's another one somewhere that's been longer outside of Australia? We haven't checked those stats.
I didn't go that deep into it, Packer, to be fair.
I know you like to go down your worm hills.
Worm hills?
Worm holes.
Layuni holding off the attentions of Vuyitsa. Ewenhoff. Marcelo. Schneidl. Turned back by Ninkovic. Balls. Happy to let the Wanderers have the ball in this sort of area. Got to try and stay compact. Wanderers trying to move them around. That is the problem with the early red card, of course. It does really change the game. Not that he got the decision wrong. Here's Clerc. Seen out by Kieran Backus. Layuni. Clerc beyond him. Near post. I think it just smacked Amalfitano in the face somewhat, really. Couldn't get any control on it.
I wasn't too sure if it was for Amalfitano or... I think it was Beedling maybe coming in at the back post. Well, the face, difficult height. Didn't know whether they get the head on it or try and chest it.
That's the one goal for Roman Malfitano for the Wanderers. That came against Newcastle. And now playing in his more preferred role. He's an attacking midfielder down the left-hand side. Virchela. Clerc. Virchela with time. Layuni. He's drawn the contact from Ivan Vujica. Which is a little needless from the ball's point of view because he was going nowhere there, Layuni.
Essentially lost possession, hadn't he? He's done well to win the foul there as well.
Murcher and Marcelo have made their way forwards. Looking to attack from the back post. Schneiderlin's delivery. And Wanderers flagged for offside.
This match already has a feel of it, doesn't it? That over time, Wanderers with the possession will wear this Macarthur team down and eventually start picking them off. Sitting so deep so early. They do win the ball, Macarthur. It's not really too much looking forward to really pinpoint a pass as Murillo makes a great run through the middle.
Just couldn't get his toe on the end of that ball. If he had gotten a touch, he fancied Curto, who'd come out to meet him. Was in a fair bit of bother there.
He's just playing with so much confidence at the moment, Brandon Barello, isn't he?
Certainly one of the form players of the competition. Tenth time this season that the Wanderers have taken the lead in an A-League match, and they are yet to lose one of the previous nine. It's a foul, though, by Malfitano, which Matt Miller is telling Kurt Amps, the referee, is his third of the game. Or at least the third time he's been fouled. Sushnia. It's an intelligent ball. And credit to Gabriel Clerc, who chased back to avoid possibility of that getting through to Al-Hassan Toure.
It was an intelligent header as well, because he was reaching a little for it. He tried to clear it to the feet of Toure. So just a little glance back to Thomas.
just tuning in on the 20-minute mark. You've missed a rather eventful opening 5 minutes. Brandon Borrello giving the Wanderers the lead from Milos Nikovic's prompt after three. And then just a couple of minutes after, Craig Noon being given his marching orders for a tackle on this player, Gabriel Clerc. To find Ewan Hoff. Wide right is Leiuni. Urchela. This is tiring work for the Bulls. Ninkovic. Able to turn at will. Here's Leiuni. Trying to trick his way through the same way he did against Adelaide late on last week to earn the Wanderers a share of the spoils. Left-footed, the Tunisian international, but it's a pretty good left back.
Yeah. Very good tight control on that left leg. Also, a nice change of pace as well.
Back by Holman for his goalkeeper. There's Craig Noon in the stands already in his early shower and in the training jersey. His evening lasted just 5 minutes.
Yeah, it was a bit of a brain snap, wasn't it, from, as I said, from an experienced player. You can't get away with anything these days. They are just watching every challenge.
Marcelo, straight at Vujica, but Ninkovic picked up the scraps. Ewenhoff, Leiuni, spotted the run of Clerc, and Clerc to the back post. Again, it's just too high for Roman Amalfitano, but once more it's straight offside.
Great run, you can see there. Great run with the ball. Sorry,
I think it was Clerc, it was offside.
Yeah, Clerc was quite a distance offside there.
Ninkovic with time to turn. Feed in Brandon Borrello. Complete miscue from the goal scorer. Although he thought otherwise.
I thought there was a touch from the defender. Obviously deceived me from up here. Yep. Good call.
Well, they're happy enough at the moment. Why wouldn't they be? If they are to win tonight, they'll go 11 points with the Mariners in second. Although they will be in third on goal difference.
Well, that's unless they win 7-0.
Well, yep.
Never know. 10 men for 85 minutes. It's going to have an effect as the game wears on.
Yeah, there's a 6-goal differential in that regard at the moment. Adelaide, who are in third. At the start of play there. Way to victory tomorrow. Brisbane against Perth, the other game on Sunday. Schneiderlin. Merchula. Out to Beedling. Oh, took his eye off it, Tom Beedling. Of a BDI.
Yes, I'm leaving that one alone.
Thought you might. Neuenhoff. Klo. Merchler to Marcelo. Liedling kept his eye on it that time. Klo again. Wanderers moving the balls around quite nicely here. Leyuni. Top of the box is Borrello. Flick of the heel. Back to Neuenhoff. Marcelo. Back out to the left at Biedling, who fires in the cross. Buschkoek there for the Bulls. He's coming back with alarming regularity, though, for Nila Stojovski's side. Schneiderlin. Marcelo. It's almost like attack v defence on the training ground at the moment. Leyuni. Again. Good feet to get into the penalty box. Marcelo sweeps it wide. Biedling drives it low. And Amalfitano again was sniffing for that opportunity at the near post. The Bulls defend that one, though.
Well there, Tommy Oscock comes across that front post. See, it's a wonderful ball into that danger area. Full stretch. It's back.
Corner roll short to Ninkovic. It's good stuff, this. By the Wanderers, and it was jabbed towards goal by Borrello. There is a flag up by the linesman on the near side, though.
That's good defending from Macarthur. Stepping up as the ball was played. Western Sydney offside.
Holman. Touré. Just about had the legs to get through to Villa. Alpitano is a man on a mission tonight.
He's up against the top scorer for Macarthur, isn't he? Just want to let him add to that tally. Want to let him get forward.
Borrello just leaning into Thomas Lavoskop. Not done anything with the free kick, though, Macarthur.
No, I think that's the last thing that they would have done. Going long, giving it away straight away. Try and have some possession, get some players positioned higher up the park.
Macarthur without a win on the road since they beat Sydney FC 3-0 on Christmas Eve. 3 points tonight looks perhaps a long shot already. No, there's still just the one goal deficit. The Wanderers totally dominant at the moment. Lawrence Thomas so unconcerned, he's almost on the halfway line. Biedling. Ninkovic. Merchula. Neuenhoff. Marcelo. I guess the fact that the balls are sitting so deep is not just because the Wanderers are playing well, but also because they've got to try and conserve some energy with playing a man short for such a large chunk of the game.
Yeah, I think you're right, Simon. I think maybe it's a case of getting through this first half.
Keep the score up one.
Yeah, and then maybe look in the second half to maybe make a few minor adjustments.
is pinging the ball about quite nicely at the moment. Beedling, Ninkovic, and they fashion an opening. Ewenhoff, Layuni. Macarthur holding their shape. Kler was a fraction heavy with that release. Just to release that little pressure valve. There's Ulysses Davila, I guess in a situation like this, he would have been a brilliant player to have on your team because he can just buy you those few seconds with his skill, his technique. Retain possession of the ball, but he's not available, of course.
Yeah, he'd also be a player that would draw the fouls, allow the clock to tick over.
Layuni. Couldn't find him, Alfatalo. With the return ball, and Sushnyas. Attempting clearance into touch, actually flicked off the Frenchman, so it'll be a ball's throw. Touré. Vuyitsa. Kieran Bacchus just helping it up over halfway. That's about the summit of their ambitions at the moment.
Yeah. It's not the first time we've seen a player flick it on to no one. Just looking to move it on, but they're sitting so deep. It's to be expected. No real targets high up the pitch when they do win it.
Schneidlin. Turned back by Beedling. Marcelo. Spotted that run of Borrello and rewarded it too. Awkward one to control for Brandon Borrello. Eventually gets away from him. Let's go back down to Tristan McManus.
Hey boys, it's not a bad game. Do you know what? I actually think, sounds strange, but I actually think Macarthur are playing better with 10 men. And that's no reflection on Craig Noon. I mean, sometimes they just get a little bit more organised when there's 10. The thing for me, and this might be misplaced judgment here, but I want to see Western Sydney Wanderers go for the juggler here. They've been playing for 26 minutes against 10 men and nothing too much has come from it. I don't think they'd be any less confident Macarthur gone in a half time. I think this is the difference between a good team and a great team. They're in no rush to get more goals, but as a fan I'd want them to get more goals and give goals back, take some goals, concede some goals later in the game, but get ahead. They just need more goals in my opinion.
Well, I agree with the sentiment of getting more goals, but not to concede goals later in the game.
No, but better get them when you're 4 or 5 ahead.
Yeah, look, I agree, Tristan. I think Marco Redam were wanting them, as you say, to go out and really snuff it out. But half-time at 1-0, Macarthur still have some hope that they're in the game.
Gabriel Kler's got the better of Alhassan Touré. Here's Neuenhoff. That shot's blocked. Layuni. On the outside is Borrello, fires it across. Curto got his palms to it. It's good defending by the Bulls in the end. Layuni. Left Bacchus on the seat of his pants. It's the right idea from Neuenhoff. De Silva can't get clear. Good stretch by Mertula. I mean, Tristan's right that Philip Curto hasn't had an awful lot of work to do, bar the goal that's got past him, of course. And that's a credit to the Bulls' defensive organisation. It has been all Wanderers, as you'd expect. And they're going to get another corner here off Alexander Sushnyar.
Well, it is hard to do, to break down 4-4-1 very deep. Edge of the box. Maybe try and go around the outside and get the crosses in behind. Very tight in the middle. Not much space.
See what Schneidlin can do with this latest Wanderers corner. It was Ertler who was underneath it who headed it back out towards Schneidlin. Back in it comes. Marcelo can't reach it. again. The flag comes to the Bulls' rescue.
Well, they have defended those set pieces well, the Bulls. And the set piece is taken, they step up very quickly. Caught Western Sydney offside now on two or three occasions.
Those two central defenders, Sushniar and Uskok, very adept at defending those aerial situations from the set pieces. Backus has lost the ball. Unfairly won, though, by Neuenhoff. Which causes a bit of angst around Combank. At least from the home fans. Vuitsa. Touré. Rare sight of the Wanderers' half for Macarthur. It's good work by Touré. Skip clear of Layuni. And he's trying to play in Alioglu. But out comes Lawrence Thomas, who's probably a bit grateful to get involved. Marcelo, Amalfitano, Mertula, Layuni, nice 1-2 with Neuenhoff, building nicely here, Schneiderle puts it into a pass, couldn't miss, Robin Amalfitano does have his goal. Just his second for Western Sydney Wanderers, and now they are too clear. That pressure has finally told on the Bulls.
Well, that's wonderful football from Western Sydney Wanderers. They've been moving the ball around for the last 30 minutes. The Harvey Norman replay shows it's that man, Amor Layuni, again with a little 1-2 give and go. Really creates the first opportunity. Lovely turn there. And then as Alay goes out to the left, Malfitano is perfectly positioned to tuck it away into the far corner. But it's a wonderful turn from Borrello. Schneiderling involved, the composure to put it into the path of Malfitano, who duly does the rest. And there's nothing that Curte can do about that.
The French connection certainly suits the Wanderers. Schneiderle into Amalfitano, and the Wanderers' goal count moves up to 23 for the campaign, and he's got two of them. And you fancy that's Miller Sajowski's team talk, just been ripped out of the notebook. Start again, Miller.
Yeah. He's got two choices at half-time, really, hasn't he? It's damage limitation, or he tries to do something inventive. He changed to a back three, put four in midfield and two up front. Something to really just go and chase the game.
Talking of which, Backus is chasing Leon. It's a good challenge at the end. Miller. Finding Alioglu. Tano chasing back. This is probably one of the best performances I've seen Romano Malfitano put in all season. He's played pretty well in the centre of midfield alongside Neuenhoff, and clearly enjoying himself tonight, playing in that wider, more advanced role.
Well, look, his performance is in the midfield. Never told me he was a winger. I would have thought he was a midfielder. He had some accomplished performances in there. Now he's got his goal in that wide position, but this man for me is exciting. Layuni picks up the ball, always looking to get the defender on the back foot. Very quick feet, change of pace, always looking to combine as well.
A little off the ball collision there between Beedling and Holman, and Beedling is going to go into the book for that. just blocked off the run of Jake Holborn. As Ali Ugla made progress. Yellow card for the Englishman. Born in Barrow, in Cumbria. Get some reward before half time. Not with crosses like that, unfortunately, from Touré.
It's difficult when you look up. It's Daniel De Silva in the box. Two towers of Mertzela and Marcelo either side of him. It's not much of a target there.
Just looking at the Macarthur bench, which does include Daniel Arzani tonight after he was left out of the match day squad against the Jets. Last week, he's certainly the sort of player that can make something happen out of nothing, and nothing is pretty much what they've created after going a man down. All too easily broken up by the Wanderers. Here's Neuenhoff. Arthur dare not concede a third before the break. Then it really is damage limitation, you'd think. Backers looking for an option, and there wasn't really one available. The Wanderers win it back high up the field. Beedling, his shot deflected, and Curto will grab it.
You said it, Simon. It does feel a bit like a training exercise. Attack versus defence. The defence win the ball. They have to give it back to the attackers and come again.
That would have suited you down to the ground, wouldn't it?
Never complain, anyway.
Schneidlin. Lovely release. Leuni. Sky's ball looking for that run of Ninkovic, but it was also read well by Jake Holmer, but immediately turned over again by the Bulls. Squared up by Neuenhoff. Borrello. Beedling. Driving into the box. Matt Miller prevents the corner. Schneidlin, nicely done by the Frenchman. Neuenhoff, his first goal for the Red and Black against Adelaide in that crazy 4-all draw at Cooper Stadium last week. Leuni, who's leading Buyata, merry dance here. Look at that for a ball. Amalfitano's cross, out by Sushnir, retrieved by Marcelo. Set up again. Tomislav Mertzela thought about the shot, I think. Now the chance perhaps for Danny De Silva to spring clear. And there's a counter on here for the Bulls. Alhassan Touré is left. And the angle was just favouring Marcelo, who used all his experience there.
They did well there, Marcelo. I think if Touré would have kept his run behind him, it might have opened up the ball in behind. He moved across the front of Marcelo. He gave him the impetus to go and guide him away from goal.
Silva waving away that run from Matt Miller, which was tracked by Amalfitano. Good turn by Ivan Vujica. He's the left back, remember. This is the number 10 in that attack. And a challenge from behind by Backus. Kurt Adams has got a check on the welfare of the Wanderers player, but has allowed play to continue. Miller across the face. That could so easily have gone in. It's going to be a Bulls corner, and the Wanderers are holding a bit of an inquisition with Kurt Adams as to why he didn't blow for a foul.
Well, I'm wondering the same thing here as we see on the replay. Ninkovic just dinks the ball around the corner. Backus seems to clearly contact with him. He asks him, is he okay? And then allows play to go on.
Into first half stoppage time. Could be a key moment, this, if the Bulls can pull one back. Uglas corner. And it came off Bushcock last, although he protested, didn't. And Milos Dijovski and his new assistant, Jacob Burns. They've got a very, very difficult half-time team talk ahead. In fact, Jacob Burns has been sent down the tunnel to get ready. That whiteboard might be full by the time the players get there.
Well, it will be interesting to see how the second half pans out. How Macarthur do react to the situation.
It's Backus on Ninkovic again. Two in the space of a couple of minutes. Clash of heads. Ninkovic is a trifle groggy on the deck. They've got to be careful with these sorts of problems, of course. Make sure that he's not concussed. Glancing blow off the head of Kieran Backus. You can sum up the first half for us.
One way. Well, a real rush of the blood to the head for Craig Noon has really put his team under the pump. It's been a training exercise for Western Sydney on breaking down a fixed defence, an organised defence. So far, they're winning that battle.
Is there a third before the break? For the Wanderers, two additional minutes are up. Fleur out off Buyitsa. Is there going to be time for the corner to be taken? Looks as though there might be. The Bulls know they must survive it. Schneidlin to take. He's got one assist already. A jockey for position. Schneidlin towards the near post. And Backus was there. And that is half time. Well, the first 5 minutes really have been pivotal. Brandon Borrello with the opening goal after 3 minutes. And then just 2 minutes after that, Craig Noon seeing red for a challenge from behind on Gabriel Clare. Roman Amalfitano added a second on 37 minutes. The Wanderers have really taken the Bulls by the horns, you could say. And they're looking well set to repeat that big win that they got over Macarthur on New Year's Day. Two clear at the break. Western Sydney Wanderers 2, Macarthur 0. Talking of breaks, we're off to one ourselves on the other side of it. Join Tara Rushton, Alex Brosk and Scott McDonald as they run the rule over all the first half action.
This year's Alex Tobin Medal is brought to you by Isuzu UTE. It's going bigger and better than ever, with the winner of the prestigious award receiving $10,000. Plus, the Isuzu UTE Alex Tobin medalist will nominate a junior football club of choice to win a brand new top-of-the-range Isuzu D-Max or 7-seat MUX during the grand final in May. To stay in touch with the leaderboard, tune in for weekly updates at your new home of football.
And welcome back to Combank, where Western Sydney Wanderers are in full control here against Macarthur Bulls, leading 2-0 at the break to 10-man Macarthur. What's going to happen in the second half here? But it looks at things, Aspro was warming up on the pitch. Looks like Bulls might be going into a bit of damage control. For me, I mean, I'm a glutton for goals here. So I'm looking at this four-goal swing at the top of the table. If I was Western Sydney Wanderers, I would be going for the juggler. It's pineapple on pizza time, guys. Do you get rid of them or do you absolutely terminate them? They're looking very, very strong, but possession doesn't win games. They need to put them to bed here because we know if you don't go to bed, you're going to get cranky. Second half is a minute away.
Pineapples on pizza? Not for me. Don't know about you, Danny, I'm afraid.
All day, every day.
Really?
Yeah.
Philistine.
We do disagree on a lot, don't we?
Yeah. I don't think there are too many smiles in that Bulls dressing room after the way the first half has gone. There's plenty in the RBB. Behind the goal away to our left, Morgan Schneiderlin has got his first assist for the club. We are going to see the introduction of Jonathan Aspropotamitis at half-time. There he is in conversation with goalkeeping coach Glenn Moss. And we are told it is Alhassan Toure who's going to be replaced. So not only two attacking options left on the pitch for the Bulls, but we'll see how they line up. You suggested, Danny McBreen, that maybe they might go to a back three. Is that the way you see this reorganisation?
Well, yeah, we know this Macarthur team. They've had plenty of times with a back three in the past, and it gives them the opportunity to push someone a little further forward and stop that ball from being moved side to side so much.
Well, a very tough half-time team talk for Messrs. Stojowski and Burns. Matt Miller certainly won't need too much encouragement to get forward down the right-hand side, but Roman Amalfitano has been pretty good tonight, his direct opponent, and of course has already capped off his performance with just his second goal in Wanderers colours. So the Wanderers looking to move level on points with the Mariners in second on the A-League ladder. Those two face off here in Parramatta next week. That'll be some game.
Well, it will be an exciting game, and I think Western Sydney Wanderers should be looking tonight to get as many goals and increase that goal difference as much as possible tonight. They're going to get an opportunity very often to play 85 minutes against an opposition. Really need to take that. Goal difference could be a real factor towards the end of the season with the tightness of this league this year. Could be the difference between home games, travelling away.
Well, just to make the finals would certainly be success of a sort for the Wanderers. They haven't been in the end of season playoffs since 2016-17. Marco Redan's team well placed to end that miserable run. Won a game in the finals since that crazy 5-4 game against Brisbane in 15-16. Remember that one? 5-4?
Yep. Fantastic game, that one. Yep, but Marco Rudan's not going to settle for finals, is he? He said, stated publicly that he wants them to be a top two team. Thinks they should be. Had a couple of opportunities in the past few weeks to try and take that spot. Falling short. Still another 8 games after this to go.
Worked out wide by Backus for Vujica. Goal for the Bulls. Make it a bit more interesting. It's of course the scene of Macarthur's greatest triumph in their short history, winning the Australian Cup in October last year. Morello, strong run as per usual. Amalfitano went with the outside of the boot. It's Layuni. Sort of swung a leg at it. And it's Curto. Prevents the corner, or does he know?
Well, that is the danger for Macarthur. Commit more players forward. I was just about to say before they lost the ball, this is probably the most possession they've had in the match for an extended period. And when you give that ball away, there will be some space at the back for Western Sydney to maraud forward into.
Attacking the red and black block end of the ground. Wanderers corner. Schneiderlin's delivery out it pops and wide by Malfitano, and did take a flick off a Bulls defender. Another corner, Western Sydney.
Beedling, who just miscued his header. Yeah, you can see there, he's disappointed in himself.
Variation on the theme, Schneidman looking to hang it up to the back post, but Curto with an unchallenged claim. Of course, will stay in the mix for the finals, even if they do lose tonight. They were third after round nine. They have slid down the table. They could be ninth by the end of the weekend if Perth win tomorrow. Here's Roman Malfitano, who's having a night to remember, and he's earned his team another corner off Kieran Backus.
It's starting to feel a little bit like normal service is resuming. First few minutes, Macarthur had a little bit of possession, but it's pressure from Western Sydney again.
Schneidlin again on corner kick duty. Deeper this time. Headed out and away by Ushkov. Wanderers will reset. Layuni. Backus in the way. Ewenhoff. Marcelo out for Morgan Schneidlin. Amalfitano. Ewenhoff. Gabriel Clerc was thinking about the shot, I fancy, before Backus took it off his toe. And Silva gets up towards halfway. The next bit, though, is the tricky bit.
They've done well to keep possession there. We do see when Carter wins the ball, Miller is as high as possible.
Ali Urglar playing the central striking role now. On the ball. Getting away from Schneidlin. The Silva. Bushcock. Malfitano. Jack down to leg. Back on their home deck next week against Brisbane Roar before they too face the Mariners 5 days after that. Ewenhoff. Brandon Borrello, narrow angle, held up by Curto. Layuni, after he was teed up by the perseverance and persistence of Callum Ewenhoff, and Curto called into action.
Another great run from Borrello. Pace and power. Curto called into the first save and a little bit lax there in defence. Curto again in the second save, keeping his team in the contest. Great reactions for the second save.
Now, Ewenhoff protesting that he was perhaps impeded, and Kurt Amt is going to come and have a look at the VAR screen for the second time in the game. Does that foot go through Callum Ewenhoff?
Yeah, he gets his foot there first, I think. Certainly, it was a little relaxed and slow to get the clearance, and I think he was surprised by Ewenhoff, who just nipped in front.
Does he kick that heel of Callum Ewenhoff?
Yeah, clear as day.
Yeah, looks like it, doesn't it? Fancy this might be a penalty. Sushniar did not see Ewenhoff on the blind side. and kicked through the Wanderers midfielder. Kurt Amps in conversation with Chris Beath in the VAR room. He's made one big decision in favour of the Wanderers in the early part of the game. This could kill it once and for all if it goes the home team's way. He's had 5 or 6 different looks at it from different angles. What's the verdict? Penalty. Now the next thing is there going to be some sanction for Sushnyar? There has been a yellow card shown to someone on the Bulls bench. Jacob Burns, we understand, has been cautioned for something set. Maybe Sushnyar escaped sanction given that it will be deemed to be a football challenge. They could be punished severely enough in any case. Now, Philip Curto, of course, as we mentioned at the start, is something of a penalty-saving specialist this season. He's stopped 3. One from Robert Mack against Sydney, although Patrick Wood did score the rebound. And then, miraculously, 2 in that game against Wellington Phoenix. He's going to be called upon to be the ball's hero once again. Having a little chirrup in the ear of Morgan Schneidlin, who's more than experienced enough to try and block that out, of course. The Frenchman charged with the responsibility of perhaps ending Macarthur's resistance here tonight. Kurt Amps is not happy that there's some encroachment in the box. Finally, after that long delay, we're ready to go in front of the red and black block. It's Morgan Schneiderlin, and he has his first goal for Western Sydney Wanderers. Runs to celebrate with those in red and black behind the goal. And Marco Redan's team have 3 goals and surely now 3 points.
Well, it's a goal for Morgan Schneiderlin, but it's a goal due to the persistence of Callum Neuenhoff. The Harvey Norman replay shows clearly there. Gets his foot in front of Alex and Sushnyar. Schneiderlin steps up. Wonderful penalty. Curto goes the right way, but enough elevation to put it away.
He almost gets a glove on that, doesn't he, Curto? Gets the right way, but too much power.
Well taken. Lifted it sufficiently enough. And the game really does have a feel now of how many for Western Sydney.
Well, it's only his second match in the starting 11 for the Wanderers. Before that, he hadn't played a game since March 2022, but he started to show that Premier League pedigree, a goal and an assist tonight. And it would take a miracle, surely, now for the Bulls to come back from this. And they're hungry for more. Why wouldn't they be? Milos Dojovski can only sit and watch. Goal difference has moved up to +7. Mariners are +10. Barring a miracle, they will both be on 28 points tonight. And it'll be second against third, depending on what Adelaide do, of course, against Victory tomorrow. Here at Combank Stadium next week. Uni. They all fancy joining in here. Neto out to grab it. If you've ever been in this situation, I'm sure you have at least once during your career, Maka, where you lose a teammate early and you're really up against it, you go two or three down. The minutes must feel like hours.
Yeah, correct. All you can do is just keep working. It's about damage limitation.
Schneiderlin. Beedling. Malfitano. Not quite cute enough to get over the top of Ushkov. Back is being harried and harassed by first Neuenhoff and then Ninkovic. Who'd be Ali Uğurlu at this moment in time, just doing doggies, isn't he, across the field, trying to get a touch.
Also thinking about, you're going to have to use substitutions just for the legs. And it's the worst situation to go on and as a substitution. You know you're going to get very limited touches of the ball. You're going to do a lot of running. It's a thankless task.
Ninkovic looking for the give and go, the wall pass with Malfitano. Didn't quite come off. Bringing out all the boxes of tricks now, the Wanderers, why not? 3 points all but pocketed. There's a look at the As Live ladder, which shows that goal difference creeping ever closer between two New South Wales teams. Adelaide, of course, in action tomorrow against Victory.
Yeah, and I think the Western Sydney bench will be urging their team on. Come on, let's really put them to the sword. Let's try and match that Central Coast Mariners goal difference, if possible, tonight.
Jared Carluccio is going to be with us for the Wanderers' next break in play. Into the box, Neuenhoff, it's four, and Callum Neuenhoff has goals in back-to-back matches for Western Sydney Wanderers.
Well, I'm not too sure that that was the pass that was intended, but they were lining up. Harvey Norman replay will show they shift the ball from one side to the other. And as Macarthur are trying to get across, there's Western Sydney attackers in a row. Ninkovic just overruns it. Neuenhoff holds his run, and it's a sublime finish. Tucks it away in the bottom corner. And they're enjoying themselves tonight. Nice finish, composed. Almost very similar to last week for Neuenhoff. Found himself unmarked in the box. Passed it into that bottom corner. Marco Rodin likes what he sees.
Well, it's becoming a bit of a procession for Western Sydney Wanderers. It was 4-0 against the Bulls here on New Year's Day. It's 4-0 again tonight, and we've still got half an hour to go. Jared Carluccio has replaced Gabriel Kler, by the way, whilst you're watching those replays. The Wanderers' first change of the night. This is turning into an evening to forget for the Bulls. Brandon Barrow. He just spotted Philip Curto off his line. He was a long way out. That's the sort of confident mood they're in. Gabriel Kler's night's work is done, but he was involved in one of the big talking points. The opening 5 minutes of the game, that's rather rudimentary tackle on it by Craig Noon, which sent the Bulls down to 10 men. They were already a goal down at that point, and they've never really recovered.
They haven't recovered. They not recovered. They are copping more blows as this game goes on.
Of course, we talk about the goal difference in the positive sense for the Wanderers, but it's equally applicable for Macarthur at the other end. Their goal difference is now blown out to minus 11, which is more than most of the other teams around them.
Yeah. And it's 22 goals away from home this season.
Sajowski's going to make a double change shortly. We're going to see Charles Mbogwa and Daniel Arzani off the bench. Time, can they try and fashion something? Miller, though, is caught offside. It'll give the Bulls the chance to make those changes. Ali Ugler, who had the thankless task of trying to lead the line with the Bulls down to 10, is withdrawn. His starting debut for the club in favour of Daniel Arzani, and Jake Holman gets his number called, Charles Mbogwa on in place of him.
Some fresh legs for Macarthur, they try and stem the tide.
Arzani making his return after missing out on the matchday squad against the Jets last week. Here's Schneiderlin. Tied it up by Sushnia. And then Bacchus is Miller. Mbogwa. That's better from the Bulls. Nice release from De Silva. Matt Miller into the box. Had to take it on his own. Didn't have much support. And now they've left them short-handed. At the back, Macarthur. Driving through the gaps is Amor Layuni. Thought about the shot. Actually turns it back for Amalfitano. Carluccio joining in with the attack. Schneiderlin. Back to the familiar pattern.
It's a nice message of play from Macarthur. First shot on target in the match.
Daniel Arzani just received the ball there and had a little look up. And there was nobody there. Now they've arrived in the Wanderers' half of the field. Matt Miller. Trying to go through a gap that was pretty non-existent from our vantage point, and then appealing in vain for a penalty. He is going to get a quarter.
I'm not too sure there was any contact for a penalty. His legs just stopped working, maybe under fatigue.
I'm pretty sure Matt Miller actually prayed to the light. He's worked hard tonight, Miller. They all have. They've had to. And they find some crumb of comfort here. De Silva. Mbogwa. De Silva back out for Arzani. Really, from a set piece like that, Macca, why would you not just throw the ball into the box? You got Sushnia, you got Uskok.
Yeah.
Miller's good in the air.
They haven't had an opportunity to get those players forward tonight, and there was two or three occasions there where the cross could have been thrown in.
Maybe a wasted opportunity. Arzani. Nicholas Milanovic are standing by to be introduced for the Wanderers. De Silva. Now Matt Miller's a bit unlucky there. There's the two new introductions, or will be. Nicholas Milanovic, who still Western United's top scorer despite leaving the club in the January window. Amor Layuni gets his number called. Go done well again. It's a good acquisition, doesn't he, Amor Layuni?
He does. Very positive, technically very good. Good turn of pace as well.
And Miloš Nikovic on his comeback. First start for the Serbian since the Sydney Derby back in November. He is replaced by Oli Bozanic. Shouldn't call him a Serbian these days, should I, Nikovic? He's an Aussie. He's got his passport. Van Dinkum Miloš.
I'm sure he likes some Vegemite on toast.
Alfonsano not quite able to prevent the corner. Taken quickly by Arzani. Invite the Silva. Scott couldn't quite reach it. Here's Backus. Did it come off the arm? Good. Ant says yes.
Well, he showed good anticipation there, Backus, and a desire to get there. As the ball bounced off the pitch, it just spun a little into the arm.
Into the section for Matt Miller. He's tried his absolute best to give them some forward thrust after the early dismissal of Craig Noon. Takes his leave to be replaced by Jake McGing. Sighted an awful lot this season, Jake McGing in Bulls colours. Was the first proper born and bred local to sign for the expansion club. Job of keeping tabs on Amalfitano, who's drifting inside here. Ewenhoff. Milanovic. Oh, don't forget the ball, Nick. Sniper got him.
Get the clown music out over the top of that one. It's on the highlight reel.
Here's the best news of the night for the Bulls. We're into the last 20 minutes.
Feel like another 40.
Bozanic. Scored an absolute worldie, you might remember, against the Bulls on New Year's Day. Although you still maintain his first touch was a miscue.
Yep. To this day. Second one was sublime, first one wasn't great. Just wonder if Oli Bozanic would feel himself a little hard done by not starting. I thought he'd been very good for them in that attacking midfield position.
Well, he shows that he's got competition for places, though, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Quality players, too. He can take off Johnny Warren medalist twice over in Miloš Nikovic and replace him with Sokaru in Oli Bozanic. You know, you've got fair depth. Yeni Mbakoto still to come back.
It's the makings of a good squad to challenge now, isn't it? A couple of little additions in the transfer window. Strengthened again.
I should include Adama Traore in that, of course, as well. Suspended tonight for his red card against Adelaide last week. Nearly as damaging as the one shown to Craig Noon in the early part of tonight's game. Beedling. In pretty sharply to the edge of the D. Aspro Potomites ensured that Borrello didn't get a piece of it. There's no way out for Macarthur. There's Adama Traore in the stands. And a few of his non-playing teammates as well. Getting a Pocoto in the background. After just 3 minutes, with his seventh of the campaign. Keeping the ball moving pretty quickly, the Wanderers against a tiring Bulls outfit. Milanovic, Schneiderlin, almost taken away from it by De Silva, but not quite. For Marcelo. Neuenhoff. Aspro Potomitis in the way. Sushnia. He's done well. And centre back. Terrific play from Sushnia. McGinn. Outside him is Arzani. And still Arzani. Hands, too many bodies in the way.
Well, the substitutions have had an impact on this match, haven't they? Relentless pressure has eased a little bit. Maybe the Sydney Wanderers have taken the foot off the accelerator, 4-0.
Clean sheet again, of course. I've had plenty of those this season. Well set for their seventh of the campaign. In truth, the Bulls have barely laid a glove on them. Maybe that sounds a bit obvious given that they play most of the game with 10 men. It doesn't always work out that way. Here's Arzani. They could yet trouble the scorers. Daniel Arzani. Just one touch too many. And in the end, it's a goal kick.
He didn't have too much options, did he? It's the one run from Charles Mombwa. Just dragged the defence, allowing Arzani to go inside. He thought he'd won a corner.
Another change for Macarthur. Jerry Skotardis is going to replace Danny De Silva. Began tonight with such high hopes, playing in a more attacking role. Well, that quickly went out the window when Noon was sent off. Although, I think he did play for about 5 or 10 minutes as a false nine.
Task of running around on his own up front, chasing a ball, without getting much joy of touching.
Tano sent it a bit wide for Bezanic, and he was offside anyway. Earlier games today, Western United got a 3-1 win at the Newcastle Jets. A couple of goals for Noah Bottic, one for Tongo Dumbia. Becca Mikkeltansa with the only response for the Jets. Keeps Western United in touch, just about. And in the other game, Melbourne City beating Sydney 3-2. Another couple of goals for Jamie McLaren, one for Marco Tilio. even a late goal for Thiago Caballo for Sydney. So City 9 points clear at the top. Who's going to join them in the finals? Well, Wanderers looking pretty good things at the moment. Macarthur, big question mark.
That's a huge question mark at the moment, isn't it? Difficulty of coach leaving mid-season. It's their star player in Uli Davila. Themselves in more of a quandary. With a red card today after 5 minutes from one of their most experienced players.
Well, could be a chance here for the Bulls, and they've blown it. Sushnia with a chance to atone for the concession of that penalty. He couldn't get his shot on target.
And of all the people that you'd expect to be getting a strike in the opposition 6 yard box, it wouldn't be one of your central defenders. But there he was.
Wanderers going to go to the bench again. Daniel Wilmering to replace Tom Beadling. And Callum Neuenhoff, who got in on the scoring act tonight, is replaced by Kasuni Yenge. To go. The results since put beyond doubt. Intriguingly, the Wanderers tonight, Macra have had just 5 shots on target despite all their dominance, and they've scored from 4 of them.
Yeah. As you could say, they're clinical. Maybe 5 shots on target. Maybe you could say they haven't done too bad at keeping them away from the danger area.
Barello.
I'm saying that, it is for him.
That's a clever release by Arzani. Mombwa needs support, gets it from McGing. He's in position for the return, and he will make it. Wanderers just a little bit stretched, but should be able to sort things out from here. And Barello is dragged to the ground. Sushnia, who gets a yellow card, did get one for conceding the penalty, and he has got into the book there.
That's great work rate again from Barello. Gets back inside and gets a coat hanger for his troubles. That's there. Sushnia was beaten. Well, I can't let him get past me. There was a forward runner. Not even able to release. Yellow card.
The trick now for the Wanderers, of course, is to go and back that up against the Mariners next week. That's a real test of their credentials. They haven't won back-to-back games in the competition this season since rounds 1 and 2. It's the next little mini-goal, if you like, consistency.
Yeah, and they'll look at that match and see that the Mariners are without their head coach, Montgomery, on the sideline. No Brian Kaltak. Triantis away with the national team.
No Maresh.
There's an opportunity for them to get one over on the Mariners. That would be it.
interesting emotions the Bulls have had at this stadium over the last 6 months. Lifting their inaugural piece of silverware late last year. Two subsequent trips here have brought two absolute wallopings.
It does seem a long, long time ago, doesn't it, that result? Australia Cup. Here's one man that they would love to have back out there.
Marcelo. Daniel Wilbery, fresh off the bench, as is Yenge. And Bozanic. Mertula. Schneiderlin. Amalfitano. And Milanovic has got away from Sushkiar. Could they make it five? He just ever so slightly overran it, didn't he, Nicholas Milanovic?
Looked like he was about to release a strike or a cross. It was a great run and a lovely ball in behind. And just as you thought he was about to cross or strike, he just had a heavy touch. Put him under a tight angle to try and get the ball back.
Schneiderlin, Wilmering, gets it back off Yenge. Milanovic. Right tap by Schneiderlin towards Amalfitano, crosses early. In the air off Aspropotamitis. Morello trying to bring it down. He's got the better of Vujica. Sushner across to help. And then Skotaris desperately trying to get the balls out of a hole. All he can do is put it out for a throw. Shirts off in the red and black block. Well, that was a Wellington Phoenix thing. The 80 minute mark. Maybe it's just a warm night.
They're enjoying themselves, aren't they? Pretty fine voice tonight.
To make progress. Wanderers have won it back. The ball stretched. It's Borrello. Not quite into those fans behind the goal.
Well, he's an ever-present danger, isn't he? Hustles his way through.
Well, the Bulls fans at the opposite end of the grounds. Too many of them. They're staying to the bitter end. That's what true fans do. Got to be there, thick and thin. Amalfitano, Milanovic, Bozanic. Jabs it out wide for Carluccio. Schneiderlin. Yenge left his return a bit short. Skotaris pounced. Arzani. Aspropotamitis. touch by Mombo is a good one. Azani. Yeah, boy, it's a free on the left. He does get a free kick. Might have been better playing the fullback in.
Made a great run. And it's up. Looked to have the better of his opposition. Free kick it is.
Not much doubt about who's going to take it. Hassani sent everybody away. I don't think he's in much of a mood to pass the ball. Lawrence Thomas has to get that wall set up right. I reckon Hassani's going to have a dig here. Yep. Disappointing.
Rather sums up the night, doesn't it, for Macarthur. It's been a long, drawn-out affair with little to no joy. It's going to be a long week of training as well. Brisbane Roar next week, who are bottom of the table. It'll be a massive game for Macarthur to bounce back, to keep themselves in that finals fight.
As it stands, there's just 3 points still between Bulls and the top six, so they're by no means out of it. Not on a particularly good run at the moment. Not too friendly between Aspro Potamitis and Amalfitano. Carluccio's trying to play peacemaker. Aspro Potamitis just thinks it's funny.
Well, it's the 90th minute, it's 4-0. Let's just see this one out. 5 minutes.
He's been fired up the whole game, yeah. Amalfitano. Certainly reminded people tonight that Morgan Schneiderlin is not the only Frenchman at the squad in the club. Minutes to be added. It's probably brought a groan from the Bulls bench. They are hanging for the final whistle. Svitanis rides that challenge from Borrello, and a couple more. Well played, Jerry Skatadis. Vuitsa. Arzani. Bacchus. Buscock. McGee. That's where it breaks down for the Bulls. Bazanic getting the better of Arzani. Borrello just didn't quite have the legs, did he? Get there ahead of Sushnia. Swin will equal the Wanderers' biggest of the season, which was against the Bulls, that 4-0 win on New Year's Day, as Arzani goes into the book. And a win that, to be fair, Acker was badly needed, even though they've played well in recent weeks. They've had a succession of draws, Western Sydney. So 3 points really were a must tonight, especially with the ladder being so tight.
Yeah. As we said, had numerous opportunities to hold of that second spot, failed it every time. This really does set the platform for next week. Get back-to-back wins, well, sitting pretty.
Ball have gone dead, it's going to be a goal kick for the Bulls. The last 2 minutes here in Parramatta. Those home supporters return happy to their abodes tonight. Is there a cherry on top for them? Zanuck having to turn and run. Zani caught in possession, but unfairly so. Surely off the arm, that's Boscatanis. Play on, says Kurt Amps. Wilmering. Final 60 seconds. And the ball's ending really as they started. Finding it very difficult to get out of their own half. Ulysses Davila cutting a lone figure in the stands. Total silence on the Bulls bench. It all went wrong for them very, very early tonight. And all the plans that Milos Stojowski would have worked upon during the week, all to no avail when you find yourself a goal down and a man down after just 5 minutes, which they did. And as it was on New Year's Day, in the end, so it turns out to be again for Western Sydney Wanderers. Another 4-0 win against the Bulls. Their joint biggest home wins of the season. The two old playing colleagues share a friendly word, or at least I hope it's friendly. But it's the Bulls who are put to the sword once again in Parramatta. The Wanderers with just their third win in 12 games. And a vital one at that as they move back into joint second alongside the Mariners. That row between Aspro Potamitis and Amalfitano continues on the field. As for the Bulls, well, they continue on the slide. 3 losses in 5 now under Milos Stojowski. And they remain out of the final spots for another week at least. Varello, Amalfitano's excellent tonight. Morgan Schneidlin with his first for the club from the penalty spot. And Callum Neuenhoff with his second in 2 games. Marco Redan doesn't look too happy. He knows Sam Krezovic, the CEO, of course, of the Bulls very, very well. He was his boss at Sydney United. It does end in a hug. I don't quite know why he's such a bad mood. His team has been very, very good tonight. An evening to remember for the Wanderers, and certainly one to forget for the Bulls after that early dismissal of Craig New. Full-time scoreline in Parramatta, Western Sydney Wanderers 4, Macarthur 0. Let's get down to Tristan.
Thanks, Simon. Yeah, I'm here with Amor Leuni. Amor, 2 games, a goal and an assist. You must be enjoying your start to your A-League career.
Yes, absolutely. No, it's been... I come here to play and enjoy football, and I'm doing that, so that's the most important.
How did the move come about? I mean, how did you get in contact with the club first? Where did they find you? Is the league what you expected it to be?
I don't know, I think the coach called my agent and they had a chat, and then the coach called me and I have a good chat, and very excited to be here. And yeah, of course, it's I didn't expect it to be such a good fields here, and the fans and everything, the big stadium, but that took me by surprise. But it's very nice, it's lovely.
You must have expected the impact that you're having on this team, especially that assist today as well. I mean, your team, they're full of tough workers, skill as well. You're so composed on the ball. You're really calm up there. Is that a huge part of your game?
I didn't have an assist today. No, I didn't. Last game I had.
So your run for the first goal, you made the run to get it.
Yeah, of course. No, that's my playing style. I like to go one-on-one, and that's when I enjoy football, and that's what I want to do. Accompanate and play, and just makes me happy.
And professionally, it's going well. Personally as well, your family are coming over soon. You have a little girl as well.
Yeah, I miss them, of course, so much. But that's football. That's life of a footballer. We need to take some decisions sometimes. But they will be here in a couple of weeks, so I'm very, very excited.
Very strong start for the team. You guys can go all the way?
Absolutely. We have a very good quality on the position, I think so. We are our own opponent now, so just keep going.
And how good is this?
It's fantastic. It is.
Plenty more goals. Yeah, have you got a goal target now until now in the end of the season?
No, as I just take one game at a time, try and enjoy my football, and football makes me happy. So if I score or my teammates score, I'm happy.
Great to hear. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Great to have you in the league. Good on you. Thank you.